Okay, good morning, or afternoon or evening, depending on when it is. This is a video on Niels Bohr and his contribution to the understanding of the atom. Up until this point, we have Rutherford, Thomson, who gave us the electron. Rutherford, who gave us the structure, which means there's a nucleus, and outside nucleus is electrons. And what Niels Bohr did is he gave a more correct explanation of what's happening to the electrons. What he did was he basically said that the electrons can't be anywhere outside the nucleus. They must be in discrete locations. So what I showed you here is in a little example of a nucleus, and the little dotted lines are what's called the energy levels, which are the discrete distances away from the nucleus, that the electrons can reside in. Now, as part of his theory, what he did is he created a coordinate system outside the nucleus where the distance the electron is away from the nucleus is equivalent to how much energy that electron has. So the further out you go, the more electrons, more energy that electron has. But the big thing is the electron can't be in every distance away from the nucleus. They must reside in what discrete distances away, which we call energy levels. In those energy levels, the electrons still revolve around the nucleus like planets around the sun. There are 7 energy levels which correspond to the 7 rows on the periodic table. That's what his model helped with the understanding of where the electrons are located. It's kind of like onion, where the electrons only can reside on the skin of each layer of the onion and can't reside in between the skins. So they can jump from skin to skin, but they must reside on the skin itself. So that is correct, except the fact that are there energy levels? Yes. But the electrons don't, when they are in the energy levels or at discrete distance away from nucleus, they don't revolve around the nucleus like planets around the sun. They actually do something else, which we'll talk about later on. So, that is how his model explains how the electrons move. His model also explains something else about how energy and the atom interrelate with each other. So what he said about this is, and I'm going to use one electron, there's of course the atom depending on which atom you're talking about, there's different numbers of electrons, but to explain what happens with the energy, it's easier to use one electron. So let's say I have an electron, hopefully the screen doesn't wreck it. I have an electron in this energy level. Okay, it has a specific amount of energy, of course, since it's a discrete distance away from the nucleus. And it's revolving around the nucleus in this energy level. Okay, well, what's going to happen is the energy is going to come at it. And here's a bad representation of what energy looks like. And I'm not quite sure I can do this with my pens. But here comes the energy. Okay. And what happens is the atom absorbs, it's a little too high, but the atom only absorbs a specific amount of energy. Because remember, the energy from here to there, okay, is a specific energy amount. And when that electron absorbs that amount of energy, okay, the electron will jump to the higher energy level. It'll jump up to here. Okay. Now, before it jumps, the electron is sitting, basically, just the electrons revolving around the energy levels they're in. And when an atom has all its electrons in the lowest available energy level, there's a name for it. It's called the ground state. And the ground state is when all electrons are in the lowest energy level available, meaning they're all not in the first energy level. There are rules of how many electrons to go into how many energy levels. Once the atom absorbs this amount of energy, that's exactly the distance from here, where the electron is in its lowest energy level, to a higher energy level there, that exact amount of energy, that's what this arrow means, the electron then is promoted to the higher energy level right there. And now since the electron is in a higher energy level, not all the electrons are in the in the lowest available energy level. So the atom is said to be in what they call the excited state. And the excited state is when all electrons are not in the lowest energy level available. And it only requires one electron to be in not the lowest available energy level. Well, the interesting part is, once the electron goes to the higher energy level, meaning the atom is in the excited state, it instantaneously drops back down to the lower energy level, making the atom back in the ground state. And what happens is that exact energy is now emitted out into the universe. That exact amount. And now the atom is back into the ground state, and the electrons revolve around the nucleus in the ground in their lower energy levels until another amount of energy comes at it. So the atom does not absorb energy continuously. It actually absorbs energy like in bursts. And that amount of energy that the electron absorbs is a specific amount of electron. Again, the amount of energy needed to go for this electron to go from here, the low energy level, to the higher energy level. And so it's not all or any energy that will take. It will just take a specific amount of energy. Which sets up the question, which we'll answer in another video, is what do you mean energy has different sizes? I thought energy was just one thing, energy. And that will be, like I said, for another video. So, in recapping, what Niels Bohr did was, he further explained how the electron resides outside the nucleus. He said that there are the electrons can only be in discrete distances away from the nucleus. They can't be any distance away. And when they are discrete energy discrete distances away from the nucleus called energy levels. They reside in those energy levels and revolve around the nucleus like planets around the sun until the atom absorbs a specific amount of energy so they could be, the word is promoted, but we can call it jump up to the higher or a higher energy level. And there are actually seven different energy levels that they could jump to. Thank you.